School of Bushes. Good evening, everyone. Thank you very, very much for coming along this evening. A few things to begin with. Firstly, I can assure you it's going to get extremely hot in here. As you can see, we've had to black out the hall, choosing to do this in term four. In the event that there is a fire, there is five exit points. There's obviously where you came in, and you'll see these fantastic Kiwiana curtains. They're also fire exits. They just burst through those, and they're designed to open up and let you flee. So, help yourself through those. If you'd like to hang around at the end and also have a good look at those, you're more than welcome. Learning has changed, and it is changing. We've been going through quite a bit of change here at Beach Haven over the last few years. The days of studying ants for 6 weeks and clouds for 4 weeks and bubbles for another 3 weeks just because the teacher said so have gone. We now approach learning in quite a different way. We are aiming to prepare the kids for a world that we don't really know much about. The only way we can do that is to teach them to learn for themselves. The way we approach it now is we have a bigger theme, and the children take themselves on their own little journey around that theme to find out what they can and do something with that. And the something that we're doing this time is tonight, is this show. The kids have been looking at a simple theme, and that is, as you can see, or saw, it's no place like home. Each class has adopted a country and has gone off and invested out of that country in, not just simply to find out a bunch of facts, but to compare it to New Zealand and see what life is like. So they've been looking at things that interest them. What do we do for fun? What do they do at school? What do you do at home? What do you eat? What do? Your customs, your celebrations. And that forms the basis of tonight's show. There is no place like home, and our aim tonight is to prove that point to you. Thank you very much for making it this evening.
Challenge or two, so let's sail away around the world and see if what they say is true.
We'll be right back. It was Eaglehawk's turn to go out hunting, but he had a small baby to look after, and he had to travel a long way from camp. He went over to find Cove and asked if he would look after his baby while he went out hunting. Crow didn't want to look after the baby because it cried too much and disturbed the camp. Eaglehawk told him to sing to him and he would go to sleep.
In the end, Eaglehawk just handed the baby over to Crow and told him he would share his couch with him when he got back. Crow had to be satisfied with that, and Eaglehawk went off with his young friends. Crow got the baby and took it to his gunya and sat down and started singing and talking to it, but it wouldn't stop crying.
Crow got really annoyed. No way would that baby stop crying. So he went out and he got his bindi, his hitting stick, and he banged the little fella and he killed it. Crow got the baby and put it at the back of his gunya. And then everything went quiet and Crow went on with his chore.
Late in the afternoon, Eaglehawk and his men returned from the hunting. Eaglehawk told Crow he'd come to pick up his baby. He thought the baby was very quiet and Crow has hung out to sleep. Crow told him the baby was in the gunya and asleep.
He went to the gunya to get his baby and noticed that everything was really still around him. He picked up the baby and discovered he was dead. He cried out, "My baby! Crow has killed my baby!" Crow took off then and ran and hid in the middle of the thick scrub.
Eaglehawk was furious, so he told his men to go after Crow and kill him. But Crow had hidden deep in the center of the melee, and try as they might, they couldn't find him.
Eaglehawk told his friends to set a light to the melee and burn him up. "He has to be punished for what he did to my baby," he told them. So they set a light to the melee and sat back and watched the grass burn and waited for Crow to run up.
Suddenly, a black bird flew out of smoke, out of the fire. All the Eaglehawks pointed at this because this was Crow. Crow had been punished now. His bird had turned him into a black bird. Both Eaglehawk and Crow are birds today, and they still carry on the fight from when they were humans years ago.
Let's head off to Antarctica, the world's driest, coldest place. It also is the windiest, so our walker will crack a pace. So they sailed through waves as high as hills for 30 days or more, until at last the walker was tossed upon an icy shore. "Man, this place is blindingly white. How will we get to sleep? It seems to be daylight all the time. We'll have to start counting the sheep."
Windiest place in the world.
Why are you holding it together?
To keep us warm.
Is it always so cold here?
Nearly, but in the summer we're like the air fun on the ice. It was just dance.
Yeah.
Thank you. think we'd better be leaving before it's wintry dark. There's another lamb with a desert, but we'll have to watch out for sharks. And the gulls turned into giants, and like the condor they flew, they picked the little worker up and dropped them in Peru. This is the land of the Incas, of sweet potatoes and gold. They say that Machu Picchu is indeed a sight to behold.
For you.
Thank you.
Wow, you have so many intriguing instruments. What are they?
Well, this is the panpipe. And this is the ocarina.
It's made out of pottery.
And these are the Peruvian drums, and this is a ukulele, but the ancient Incas would usually use a conchonis made out of armadillo shell. They are very rare.
I heard your national bird is the condor. Can you tell me more about it?
The condor is the largest bird in the world. It soars high above the Andes mountain range. It is the sacred bird of the Incas and an important part of South American culture. The condor flies over the mountains and protects us.
Who are the Incas?
The Incas are a race of people who lived in the 12th to 16th century. They included areas such as modern-day Peru, Bolivia, Chile, Ecuador, and Colombia. They were amazing builders and architects. Machu Picchu is the most famous of their buildings. They're still in digging some of it today. We have learned a lot from the Incans.
What does some Incan music sound like?
Okay, here's a song that is well known and sings about the condor.
Boys, why don't you start a song?
I'd rather be a sparrow.
Let's head off now to Japan, the land of the rising sun. We'll eat lots of sushi, and the sumo will be fun. It's where the kids do karate, and they invented PlayStation. They make clever origami, and have tea celebrations.
Girls' Day, Boys' Day, Peace Day, and many other celebrations. The tea ceremony is a special occasion for Japanese people.
Do you always wear kimono?
People only wear kimonos for special celebrations. They are very valuable to put on and take a lot of skill to put on.
Tell us about school.
The Japanese have 700 symbols in there. Alphabet and are tested every day on them. The children are responsible for cleaning their own schools, even the toilets. Tell you what, can we just show you some more about Japan's culture?
Okay.
Kokishi dolls are traditional wooden dolls that parents give to their children for good luck. They are traditional wooden dolls, and they are hand painted. They are an important part of Dolls Day. Origami is the art of folding paper into many designs. Every year, people send paper cranes to the Darko Monument in Hiroshima Peace Park to commemorate the many victims of leukemia after the atom bomb. Samurai are Japanese warriors who specialized in the art of kendo and defended the Japanese citizens in 200 BC period. The Japanese invented PlayStation, Donkey Kong, Mario, Nintendo, and Dragon Ball Z. They are world leaders in technology. We are having a tea ceremony. It is a ceremony where some people come together to drink tea. It is a special occasion for Japanese people, as is this traditional song. Thank you.
We'll carry on to China. It's only just over there. I noticed their name on the labels of all the clothes I wear. Great, it's New Year at the moment. They'll be having celebrations. There'll be dragons and lanterns everywhere. We'll see some great creations.
Thank you. What is the The girls are wearing kameez and cholis. The boys are wearing tunics to keep them cool from the hot sun.
How do you get around the moon here?
Lots of people don't have cars, so they ride in bullet carts pulled by bulls. People also ride on trains a lot.
What kind of food do you eat in India?
Curry, and they also like it hot, hot, hot.
Hi, what country is this?
Andrew, here's a gift from New Zealand.
Thank you.
Thank you. Is your country hot or cold?
Very, very cold.
What kind of animals do you have? What things do you like to do?
We go skiing.
They sailed up the mighty Seine, saw bridges, cathedrals and more. And when they finally stepped on land, they were greeted with bonjour.
Famous tower in Paris. The metal crisscross patterns make the tower very strong.
What food do you eat in France?
We eat lots of different kind of breads. France is famous for its cheese and wine.
I have heard that kids drink wine mixed with water. Is this true?
Yeah, us kids do drink wine mixed with water.
They saw Buckingham Palace before them and knew they'd seen it before. And they said, "We've sailed away to the edge of the world and arrived at the Queen's front door."
In England, we start school in September because our summer holidays are in July and August.
Do you need to take your lunch to school?
We don't need to take our lunch to school because we have hot dinners at school every day.
What games do kids like to play in England?
We kids like to play soccer, basketball, skipping, tag, marbles, conkers, and on the adventure playground. On weekdays, we play board games. Probably because in New Zealand, I like to play these games too.
What are some traditional celebrations in England?
We celebrate Robin Hood's Day, Pancake Day, Lord Mayor's Day, and Guy Fawkes, but best of all is May Day, where we do Morris dancing around the maple. Come on, we'll show you how it's done.
Described as being a mixture of both soccer and rugby, and it is a little bit like Aussie rules. There's another game called hurling, and it is played with the axe except that the small ball is called a slither, and it can be hit either above or below the crossbar of the goal.
What is special about Irish music?
The notes of Irish music are short and snappy, and the main instruments are the fiddle and the flute. Some bands you might know are the Calls, the Cranberries, Inya, then Lizzie, Westlife, and of course you too.
What is Irish dancing like?
Irish dancing is usually called step dance, and it is easily recognised by the fast leg movements and the body and the arms kept still during the dance.
What is the Balani stone?
It is a large block of bluestone that can be found on the castle wall. The Balani castle is in a place called Cork. The Irish believe if you kiss the stone, you'll get the gift of the gab, meaning you'll be able to feed other people and you'll become a really great talker.
You're a
youth travels fast in Ireland, I think I'll be enjoying a peaceful old age.
Upon the waves, and straight away we know the tune. Sounds like Scotland the Brave. Clocks.
Good job, you are in Holland, the land of the Dutch.
He's a boy from New Zealand.
Thank you.
He's a boy
from
What's the luck in Dutch?
If you like Dutch, you like much. We like being Dutch very much. Our windmills and our clocks. We use ducks and lots of bikes. Our land is came from bogs.
What kind of food do you eat in Holland?
Herring, licorice, blackbird too. I love their puffer jays. Holland is the place to be picking tulips on sunny days.
What kind of food do you wear in Holland?
We are doing an Olden Day Dutch dance and we are getting dressed in Olden Day Dutch clothes.
So they sailed away for many a day. Through fierce storms they passed. They headed south into the warmth, and the sea turned into glass. The wild wind sank to a whisper, the little waves were shy, and the moon shone down serenely from the sleeping depths of the sky. The four exhausted children sailed on to their sighted land. Then the sturdy little walker came to rest on Hawaiian sand.
know what country is this?
Aloha, this is Hawaii.
Is Hawaii an actual country?
No, it's not a state of America. It became a state of America in 1959.
Here is a Pahuki code from New Zealand. Why is it so hot here?
It's hot here because Hawaii is close to the equator.
What is the name of the ocean that surrounds the Hawaii Islands?
The ocean that surrounds Hawaii is the Pacific Ocean.
What do you like to eat in Hawaii?
We like to eat fish that we catch in our big nets at a hukila. Lots of people go to a hukila and sing and dance and sing about it like this.
Everybody loves the hooky love, where the law loves the cow cow at the big law. Oh, we'll throw our nets out into the sea, and all the umma umma come swimming to me. Oh, we're going to the hooky love. Hooky, 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 hooky love. What a wonderful day for fishing. The old Hawaiian way. All the hukila nets are swishing down in old Laie Bay. Oh, we're going to the hukila. Hooky, 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 hukila. Everybody loves the hukila. Where the lau lau is the cow cow and the big luau. Oh, we'll throw our nets out into the sea, and all the umma umma come swimming to me. Oh, we're going to the hooky love. Hooky, 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 hooky love. Oh, we're going to the hooky love. Hooky, 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 hooky love. Everybody loves the hooky love. Where the long lies, the cow cow at the big luau. Oh, we'll throw our nets out into the sea, and all the umma umma come swimming to me. Oh, we're going to the hooky luau. Hooky, 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 hooky luau. Hooky, 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 hooky luau.
To catch up with our friends. We can sleep in my mate's whare and eat up lots of taro, so when I go to bed at home, I like a cup of Milo.
They're different to your house because ours do not have any walls. We don't need them because it's always so hot here.
Do you play the same sports as us?
Yeah, one of our favourite sports is rugby. We also love playing kalakete, samoa and cricket. We have a longer bat than you and have over 20 people on each team.
What do you eat in Samoa?
We eat lots of taro, coconut cream and banana. We cook our food in ways which are similar to hangi. We have big feasts for special occasions, and sometimes we have other ceremonies.
What's that?
Habit is used in all sorts of celebrations. We can show you a dance that tells the story of a young girl preparing habit.
Oh, Yeah. members of Mr. Silver Ferns. But travelling around the world, you know, is the best way to learn.
We travel north, south, east and west.
Once again, good evening, and thank you all for coming along this evening. As you've seen, these are the sorts of things that involve a huge amount of people, in this case, every single one of us. Even Morris was up on the roof of the hall the other day putting bits and pieces up, so every single person in the school has been involved. There are some people I would like to specifically mention this evening, though. If we could start, please, with Yasmin, if you just make your way over here. Now, Yasmin, as you may have realised this evening, has been narrating a wee story that links the journey together. If it weren't for a particularly special person, though, Yasmin would have been very quiet this evening, with nothing to say. One of our, well, she's still with us, actually, I was going to say previous teachers, but she's still with us in part-time. Judith Burgess wrote the entire narration there. So if I could have you, Judith, please make your way to the front. It's an easy journey, there's no one in the way. Many of you may not realise Judith is quite the little scribe. And often put some fantastic little poems together, often when staff are leaving, but this time it happens to be a far more joyous occasion. Can we put our hands together, please, for you? Someone else that's had a large part to play in this evening. We didn't officially assign a director, or a producer, or anyone really. However, Leanne Carlson has taken that role on with gusto and has managed to coordinate an epic production this evening. So, Leanne, if you could too make your way up to the stage. We'll have a special gift for you. As I mentioned at the beginning of the evening, if we did catch fire, which fortunately we haven't, you were to burst through the Kiwiana curtains. Those curtains were something else, really. It was an idea born of one of our teachers. When she described it, it sounded fantastic. But to see them in person was really something else. Every few days, one would arrive in the staff room and be splayed out all over the floor and would all stand there in awe. There's around about, I think we estimated, approximately somewhere in the vicinity of 50 women, men, people hours in those curtains. We've had a huge amount of people involved, but they were, if you like, the baby, the idea, came from Karen Kumar. So Karen, if you'd like to make your own. Among all the other art direction that took place. To her helpers in particular, we can't obviously give you all flowers and a drink, but thank you very, very much, because I know she's had a huge amount of support, teachers and family and friends alike. Do you recall what your family looked like after the little vague?
You won't come with that.
Now the centre stage here at the moment, as you can see, we have this most magnificent waka, and for those of you who may not have noticed, you'll note the traditional crushed pawa highlighting or accenting the carving that's been painted on there. That again was someone's idea, didn't just happen by itself, and fortunately for us we have quite a talented parent involved with the school who offered his services. After Eden, one of our teachers put the frame together, Keith Hall actually came along and helped paint that along with the help of Donovan Bickford and of Sally Bass, one of our teachers also. Keith, if you're in the audience, could you make your way up? I'm sure it's an easy journey wherever you are. Ever the humble artist. Now, one other person who you probably wouldn't have even noticed, but throughout the dress rehearsal yesterday, the matinee today, and this evening's performance, we've had Brett Jamieson filming the entire affair, along with the help of his lovely wife, Joanne. And I'm sure he's had other helpers as well, who I'm not entirely sure who they are. Fortunately, he will be compiling all that footage into a DVD that you can purchase. There will be an order form going home on Monday with your wee ones. If you'd like to order that, there'll be pre-orders taken, and we'll be firing those out in due course. To you, Brett, thank you very, very much. Nearing the end, we have teachers, obviously, who have put in endless hours behind sewing machines, paintbrushes, to name a few things I've been behind. Without their amazing choreography, we wouldn't have seen what we saw this evening. You would have noticed some key actors, the children who travelled around the world. They have been working many, many extra hours, just perfecting their wee performances there. They've dealt with technical hitches, among other things, and they've certainly risen to the occasion. Can we please acknowledge those people? And last but not least,
you may have noticed that we didn't see Mr. Brereton most of the night, and that's because he's been hidden behind the speakers, behind the trees, and he's been working flat out with the sound and the lights. And the other day I came into the hall to find for something, and he was up a ladder trying to set up the cabling and all the system for the data projector. And he's been very flat out for many days. I think the paperwork's building up a little bit because it's been concert has taken us over. But he has done a fabulous job with his helper, Adam. Where's Adam? Stand up, Adam, over there in the corner. Adam's been helping with the visuals. He's been turning the laptop on for the pictures that have come up, and he and Mr. Brereton have put the sound and the visuals together and all the lighting systems. So a big hand for those people.
We could have a little French dinner, Adam, and Fred makes up with some water for you, that'd be nice. And, as I said, last but not least, the children. I cannot tell you how proud I've been to be part of something like this. This hasn't happened at the school. We worked out for roughly about 6 or so years. And to see it come together and to see these kids, every single one of them involved, and to get up and do what they've done this evening has just made me so proud. And, yeah, it's been just something special to be involved with. And I'd like you all to give them a giant thank you now. Okay. Now we have to get everyone home. You may have read in the newsletter that we won't be offended if your child doesn't arrive at school tomorrow. They are exceptionally tired and feel like they need an extra rest, you're more than welcome. This evening, however, they do need to return to their classroom, please. So if you can let them go with their class, with their teacher, there's many costumes and props and what have you to be organised. Once they've gotten back to their class and their teacher is happy for you to take them, then you're most welcome to take them home. So if you make your way back to your kids' classrooms and meet your children there, rather than take them from the hall. Thank you very, very much for coming.